Dear students, welcome to this online lectures of CAD CAM and CE for Unit 6 and Part 2. Today we are going to cover the advantages of CNC machines. CNC machines have large number of advantages. Some of them are, it improves the machining accuracy. Students, in conventional machines, the accuracy of the workpiece will totally depend upon the skills of the operators. Now in CNC machines, as all the parameters are controlled by the control system itself, so there is less chances of error in the machining process. Also, there are feedback element present in CNC machines which corrects this error. So there are less chances that the object or the workpiece will be rejected due to the accuracy. So CNC machines have high accuracy as compared to the other conventional machines. In CNC machines, any type of job can be machined. So we can say that it enables complex tasks detail very easily. Obviously, any complex workpiece or any complex profile will be totally dependent upon the part programmer skill. Once the part program has been created for that complex profile, it is very easy for machining of that workpiece. It creates flexibility in manufacturing. In CNC machines, large number of operations are produced, such as drilling, boring operations, different milling operation, end milling cutter, face milling, slot milling, grooving, all these things can be done in a single machining center. So we can say that the machines are very much flexible. They can perform any operations in a single machining center. Students, as we know that the CNC machines can be operated unattended for long hours. There is no operator required. Operators are just required to observe the parameters and to load and unload the workpiece. So, as there is less interference of operators in the machines, it improves and increases the safety of the machine. Second, it increases the production in volume. Obviously, we have seen that in CNC machines, we have reduced the bottleneck operations, we have removed the lead time, we have reduced the setup times, and which generally increases the large number of productions. So it boosts the production volume. It reduces the set change over time. As we are seeing that we are using the automatic pallet system, the workpieces are already loaded, so there is no need, the setup time is obviously reduced. So we are going for the next feature, that is the adaptive control system. Now what is adaptive control system? Adaptive control systems are the automated controller that control the speed and feed of the tool automatically. Consider a simple example. When you have to machine certain workpiece, the part programmer will create the part program as per the knowledge of the material, which material has to be processed, what is the thickness, what will be the depth of cut, what are the different cutting parameters, the type of coolant we are using, quantity of coolant we are using, and a standard speed and feed will be defined. And this will be entered in CNC machine, and CNC machines will be operated on that defined speed and feed. Now, it is not necessary that the part programmer should be available near the machines to create the part program. He can create the part program anywhere in the industries and just enter the program by typing the program or by using some USB drives. Now, when the actual machining operations occur and in real time operations, there are large number of errors that are coming, large number of difficulties that are producing. Suppose when you are considering a casting job, the casting has certain types of errors. In casting, some structure may be, some area may be dense and some area may be porous. Obviously, when you are moving this tool from this porous to dense structure, the speed of the tool in the porous structure will be high and the speed of the tool in the dense structure will be less. As there will be less friction in the porous structure and more friction in the dense structure. Obviously, where there will be the dense structure and if you are not controlling that speed and heat, there may be the chances of the tool to break or there may be the chances of workpiece deterioration. So in such cases, what we have to do, we have to reduce the speed and heat, and it can be done by this adaptive control system. So we can see that it is nothing but it is a logical extension of CNC mechanism in which cutting speed and slip rates are automatically controlled that are prescribed by the part programmer. So the whatever this calculation is based, the calculation is based on the measurement of process variable, real time and online adjustment parameters, which will be the different sensors that are available at that locations. We can measure the speed, we can measure the temperature arising in that region, and obviously on that we can control the different parameters. So you can see that a simple diagram of adaptive control. This is the machine tools, these are the sensors that are measuring the speed, heat or temperature. This is adaptive control to amplify the signals, and this is a controller, that is a CNC system. Obviously when the machine tool there is more friction, heat will be generated, speed will be reduced, and that will be measured by the sensor and it will be passed to this adaptive control. So adaptive control will immediately take that action, it will amplify the signals, it will reduce the speed and heat in that case. So this is the problem of adaptive control system. Next, what are the advantages of adaptive control system? It increases production rate, tool life is increased, greater part production, less operator iteration, and very easier part programming. Obviously, when there will be less human interaction in that machines, and the system is automatically adjusting the existing parameters which are due to the real time operations, and errors are automatically reduced. So obviously the accuracy will be increases, tool life will be increases, production rate will be high, there will be the safety will be increases, and part programming will become easier. So we'll end this session. Thank you.